it a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the New Orleans Saints. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he takes it into the end zone. It's a fumble recovery and a touchdown for the Panthers.
Joey Sly lining up for the point after.
So problems here on special teams, and it results in the scoop and the score.
They talk all the time on special teams about keeping your head on a swivel, trying to see the whole field. Hard to do when things are going that fast, bodies all over the place. You're just trying to find the right guy to align yourself with. On that play, wow.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And 10, Eason. The kicker here, it's complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
6-yard pickup.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
First down.
That's how you pick up a first down. You know where the sticks are. You know where the first down marker is, and you find a way to get there. That's called having vision.
He had a lot of vision last week, didn't he? NFC Offensive Player of the Week. He was dominant. On first down, Jacob Eason. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right of the yard.
The Panthers' 46-yard line. Sometimes I need a check. Had to think of what there was and make you watch a step. You change, pain, how about your respect? Get it more than when I get expected. Let the back, it's back.
Eason gonna throw it out of the shotgun. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive. But instead, third down. We documented it last week. They played so well defensively. 4 interceptions. Tried to get their hands on another one there.
And when you've had 4 the previous week, you are just itching for more the very next week. And there was a great opportunity. It went by the wayside. But let's not underscore what's going on with this defensive unit. They are around the ball every time it's being put in the air.
It's a gain of 3, and it gets him the first. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
They'll throw on first down with Eason. Throw left side, going to be taken in by Harris. And he's going inside the 30. 14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans.
First and 10.
That's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body and picks up the first down.
And they'll go on the ground. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line.
The tackle made.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
First down run, got five. Here's second and five. And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
Off the bootleg. Eason, nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and it's picked up by the Panthers. And now look at him go. And he takes it into the end zone. It's a fumble recovery and a touchdown for the Panthers. Eason sets to throw it. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Partner, this is almost an unwinnable spot for a defense. They have to come right out for a first and goal, trying to stop them. But let me hold on a second. Let me take that back real quick. They can win here if they force a field goal try. Still a long ways away from that happening, but that has to be what they're thinking right now.
So an incomplete pass a moment ago, and that leads to second and goal. Eason. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. A two-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Fourth and goal. The defense needed one more stand. They couldn't get it.
I just wonder if they were thinking heavy run here in that situation instead of being able to play the pass, and they were beaten on that possession.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. But a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. On second down, here's a keeper by the QB. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
33-yard line.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On play action. Love to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
On is the punter, Hawk, as he gets this one away. Harris now to return. It'll be a 41-yard punt, give him 5 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown, and now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. From the shotgun now. Here's an inside hill. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
38-yard line. Brings up third down.
From the shotgun now. Here's an inside hill. And he is finally going to be brought down, but not before he gets it to the Panthers' 29-yard line. That one good for 33 and a first. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. From the gun is Eason. Left side, it's complete. He's got it. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Now a first and 10 at the 11. This time to the tailback. Now the flag comes in from the umpire after a gain of about 4. And this looks like it's going to be holding.
For this offense going forward.
Behind the chain, second and 13. from the gun. Eason is thrown caught at about the five. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. These two teams all tied after one. The Saints on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Operating from the gun, Eason. In a heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Swings it for the pick. And to the 12, that's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting 3. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Following the interception, Love. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. They went 3 and out on their first drive. Things already looking better here, 1st and 10. Here's McCaffrey. And he'll wind up with about 6, up past the 30 to the 31.
Christian McCaffrey.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down.
Tackled at the 34.
Nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Lines up and lets it go for Samuel. And that's caught inside the 30. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for 1st and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. And a really good show of force there as he gets through for 4 tough yards.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The ball carried by the
Lions. A nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? And off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Lutz with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. Means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, it didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
Now an option play on 2nd down. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down.
I bet they thought they had picked that one up because it was a 3rd and 2 call, and they got awfully close. Now we're at 4th and inches. I wonder if they think they're feeling lucky here and maybe want to go pick it up.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. This is Harris. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
36-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said is, don't do that again. What do you think? So told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off at the 38, 20. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six. Panther touchdown. Free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for 6.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
The Saints take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
A first down pickup of 18 yards.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Derrick Brown.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
2nd and 10 at their 48-yard line.
Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
The Saints on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. From the gun, Eason. He took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
I'm feeling like a prince. I'm feeling myself. I'm loaded with This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. They'll try and run for it. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. A solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in his second week of the regular season. And this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He'll get this to his tight end, Troutman. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of three. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
At the Panthers' 15-yard line.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. And he'll give it here to his running back. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one.
Third down and six.
In search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the ninth play of the drive. Operating from the gun. Eason is going to find his running back. It's complete. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. And Lutz puts this one through. Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there, only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you six?
Taken about 7 yards deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
23-yard line.
Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And you have to figure they won't just sit on the football here in the final minute. The way things have gone, they need to try to make something happen offensively.
But maybe they should. Maybe they should sit on it here because of what you just said. They haven't made anything happen offensively. Getting ready to go into the half, give them a chance to take a deep breath, exhale a little bit, and start over. I don't know if this is the time to push it myself.
Yeah, right now, under 100 yards of total offense. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Throwing again. Love. He's going to look deep. He's got a man. Complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 32 on the play.
I don't think we'll ever get enough of watching one-handed catches, and when they pay off, they are spectacular. But how about the times they don't pay off and coaches go, two hands still works.
I know, but they go for them so often now that I'm almost starting to take them for granted.
Yeah, that's unbelievable, isn't it? Because these are sensational type plays.
Especially that one with a defender right there. Off the play fake, Love. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw again. Love. Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. He was looking for his tight end, Mark Andrews, there. And it's third down.
And 10 yards to go.
They will throw again here with Jordan Love. He's going to look deep for more. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
Intended for DJ Moore. It's fourth down.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. To the air again, Love. And they're going to bring him down. Back across midfield at the 35. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA with a sack. This is a quick incompletion. This is likely the last play here of this first half. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. So we have reached halftime in what's a 6-point game at the break. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
23-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And on that last drive, Woodford on fourth turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three.
And the ball comes out. Love lost him, and this is picked up by the Saints. And he's into the end zone. A fumble return, and a Saint touchdown. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
The good news, they kept the ball. Bad news, it's third and long. They got the fumble recovery. Now here's Love to pass. Steps away to his left. He's going to look deep for more. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A big third down play there for the Panthers. 49 yards. And you need a big play? Go to your big play guy.
Listen, that's football 101. When you have to have it, you expect that guy to step up. A lot of people call these receivers divas. Sometimes just leadership when they get in the huddle and say, get me the ball. I'm about to make a big play.
To Christian McCaffrey.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Complete out to Samuel on the quick throw. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Complete. 16 yards, a first down.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively, but they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll run with McCaffrey. Inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
They're going to run the sweep. It's Samuel. Reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. 3rd and 6.
And it's third down.
Throwing. Love. Set up the screen to McCaffrey. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Joey's fly under the field goal of 32.
And his kick is good. And that cuts the lead down to just 3, 20-17. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with 3.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal, because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me more.
Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll take it to the 43-yard line. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Now this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Throwing is Eason. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Troy Pride. He's had it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
It's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
They'll try to get the running game going with McCaffrey, and he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
At the 14-yard line.
2nd down. Love. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. Lutz good on the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
18-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Love from the gun. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 11 yards and a Panther first down. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. Oh, look at the juke. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
Taken down right.
Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off here the 32. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Partner's bad enough when you just can't hold on to the football. But when your quarterback's throwing it to the other team, that's 3 interceptions now, 4 turnovers for the game, you really have no chance to win the football game.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start
under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Shaq Thompson making his presence felt on the sack. And that'll be marked down as their first sack of the game.
Well, they had 6 last week, and this offense did its homework, didn't it? Because they saw all that pressure, and they really worked hard to tamp it down and beat it back. And they did a great job in the first half. But now they've gotten their first sack here in the second half. Look out. They'll try to increase the pressure.
Throw left side complete. That's Harris. And he'll be brought down in what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Saints. They'll be looking to expand their lead here. They've got the football as we start the fourth. The Saints on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. From the gun, Eason. Open man is Michael Thomas. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down.
1st and 10 at the 44-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Eason. Being chased out left. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
No grounding call there. He had a receiver near the right sideline. It was pretty clear there. He just needed to get rid of that one.
And he did have a receiver in the area, but initially my view was obstructed, and I thought that was going to be grounding, but clearly the correct call made, and that is no call.
Is that why you threw your play sheet down? Is that why you did it? Is that the flag?
You can't be giving me up. I got a lot of issues up here in the booth.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. from the shotgun now. Here's an inside hit. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 11 yards there, first down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Throwing on first down, Eason. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be marked down at the 20. Six with a gain of seven.
Complete to number 34. A 7-yard pickup brings up second and three at the 26-yard line.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Going to give this time to the tailback. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere.
Brought down.
Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave them with a third and about three to go.
Third down and four.
Here's Eason to throw. Thomas, and he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
It's a gain of
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
At the 9-yard line.
From the gun, Eason. Down man open. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans.
Touchdown, Saints.
Michael Thomas. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Play action this time with Love. Going back to Moore. This time he's got him complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Love now. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time, 18 more and a first down. Going back to Love. Flush to his right. A short throw caught by Andrews. And he's taken down inside the 30. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand.
and they'll take that.
Love now to pass on first down. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another first down.
A gain of 12.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Stepping up, he's good. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. And this is picked up by the Saints. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. 30, the 20, 10, and he's into the end zone. A fumble return, and a Saint touchdown.
Will Lutz lining up.
Oh, backbreaker. That'll drive the coach, the offensive coordinator, just crazy. You get it all the way down there in the red zone, can't capitalize. Instead, they go the other way on the fumble return for a touchdown.
How about the aggressiveness of the defense, though? They're not about to just fall on a fumble, are they? Scoop and score is their motto, and they just did it.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
On second down, Love once more. Left side by Hilton. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of six. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. The Panthers on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is third and four. Working out of the gun. Love. And that is incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time here. Love on fourth down. And this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Saints are going to get it back and in great shape. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Yeah, he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage.
Right at the line of scrimmage.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
And 6.
Takes this one down to the 15.
First down at the 15-yard line.
And they will take a knee here. Take a knee. So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for New Orleans, it's a win here in their home opener as they move to 2-0. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for Carolina, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll have a tough one at home next week against the Denver Broncos. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaud. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.